Okay, welcome to AT Modification. So basically, in this modification right here, you play as the special operation team from the Netherlands. The AT SWAT is what you would call it in America, AKS is what you would call it in Denmark. And basically, you have this station right here and you have to respond to different calls. So right now we just got a call for a wanted man has barricaded himself with a hostage, police chase gone wrong. Okay, so we will just get ready to respond. Right now we only have these four personnel and this these two vehicles, but later we can buy some more. If I could, would I go full time on this? No. First of all, I don't think there's that much potential in Emergency 4. It's not a big community, so first of all, there would not be enough money in it. Second of all, everything I do has to be free to use. So I would not even be able to make any money on it, because all the assets that I use from other modifications, I'm not allowed to take any money from. But if I could, I still don't think I would do it. I actually love the education I'm taking right now, and I'm super excited to see where that takes me. Okay, so this is the scene right here. Just like in a Wegbeer modification, you actually have to go to different scenes. And this is our units right now. We do not really have any special equipment, so we will just go down there and arrest the guy. Yes, if I had the possibility, I would use, I would love to use more time on modding. Yes, I would. But I'm not sure if I would want to do it for a living. Probably not. It's more of a hobby for me. Okay, so he's arrested. Just have to hand him over to the local police and we should be able to clear this call. There we go. How is Project Big Apple going? Project Big Apple is a project I'm having with two other guys. Dyson from the Manhattan and Brooklyn mod, and then RD Sarlander. And those two guys are two super amazing guys, and we have done a ton of work for it. Just gonna buy some more personnel. You can see... and then we will respond again. How is the mod actually going? It's standing still at the moment, unfortunately. We are at that state where all of us want to continue work, but none of us really has the time right now. Just like a lot of other modifications. We really want to do it, we just don't have the time. We talked about it, I think it was a week ago or so, maybe a month by now. And we really want to get back into the swing of things. But because of me trying to complete Airscore modification, we had to put it a bit on standby for now. And then, hopefully alongside the new rework of CP8 Airport, we can also do some more Project Big Apple. We want to include some first aid, and that's actually the hard part right now, is trying to implement that. And a lot of thought is going into how we want that system to work. Okay, so once again, we're just gonna go in and arrest him, and then we will buy some more equipment once we get back. Let's try to put him, take him out gunpoint this time. Whoops. And then we will take the police, the chief, call for backup, and we will want a transport. So now transport should be on the way. Okay, so once we get back to the station, I will buy a ton of vehicles, and then I will explain to you how the modification is going to work once it is released. Okay, so once the modification is released, we are planning on implementing a money system. So you have your money down here, and then when you want to buy new personnel or new vehicles, it will cost you money. You see right now the price is zero, but we want you to actually earn money from doing missions and then actually having to buy more stuff. And at the moment, the more personnel you have, the more missions you can go to. Like if you only have four police officers, you will not be able to go to some of the bigger missions with a lot of suspects. On personnel side, you have four different types of personnel. You have the normal officer, you have the canine dog unit officer, you have the sniper, and you have something called a rescue officer. The regular officer is just a regular AT SWAT member. He can do most actions. He can take an MP5, he can use a ballistic shield, he can take a grenade, have a normal gun, you know, all the regular stuff. Then you have the commander. He can call in extra units. You have one of these. You have the rescue officers. They have the possibility to add access, fire extinguishers, medical bag, stuff like that. And then you have the canine officer who has a dog. On the vehicle side, you have a ton of different vehicles. You have a negotiator vehicle. We want to add a negotiator later. We have some normal personnel carriers. We have a sniper vehicle, equipment vehicle, command vehicle, transport vehicle, and a dog unit. And let's say we have this mission right here. We have a suspect hiding in industrial area after a road accident. So let's say we want to respond to that. We take the two rescue officers, putting into the rescue truck. We will make sure to, just making sure that this is actually the correct vehicle. No, this is the dog unit. Of course, we'll make sure to add the signs down here telling what vehicle is what later. So we have the equipment unit, we have the sniper unit, and we will have we respond with these two officers as well. We will respond with, this is the transport vehicle, the officer. So we have right now a normal unit, a normal unit with transport, equipment unit, and the chief. We could probably also use the canine for this mission because, you know, this is a sniper right here, because you know that it's a large area. If we go up here, we have the panel for the vehicles. We can enable and disable blue lights. We have emergency lights on all vehicles. We have emergency grill lights, so we can just send them to respond. And right now the game knows that only the vehicles we have sent out on the mission will respond. And when we press this button, go to mission, only those vehicles will show up on the scene. So this is another scene. And all the vehicles should be responding here from the north. We would just turn off the siren. Let them respond to the to this incident site. You can see that right now all the officers have changed into their scene uniform with the helmets and bulletproof vest and stuff. Let's pull out the dog unit. Or not. Why is this not working right now? There we go. And now he has his dog with him. And now wherever he goes, the dog will follow. And see, you have some different commands for it. Then we have the rescue officers. They can take ballistic shields. They can take medical bags, stuff like that. And if we just take these guys and then move along, and we have to search for the criminals. You can see they are down here right now. Why do I notice? Because I made the map. Parking script. I know. I will include it. Aim the gun at that guy. And if you do that as well, oh, not arrest him yet, aim the gun, and then you can ask to chase those people right there. You see that the guy actually gives up, so now it's possible for us to go out and arrest him. So this dog right here actually tries to fight the people, and then eventually they will either give up or get injured. Just call the dog. Then we can take the commander, call for backup, and request a transport. And we next ask you to follow. And then we can, and this is basically the modification, like this is the purpose of the modification, is to make like this kind of a tactical approach to police incidents. Instead of normally you can just go in and arrest, we're trying to add some different possibilities and some more equipment. Again, what is keeping this modification back is the amount of maps we have. Right now I think we have around 10. Different incidents that you can respond to. We would love to have some more. So again, back at the station, this is the point in the game where you would be able to buy some new vehicles. From the money you just earned, you can buy some new vehicles, some new officers, and then slowly you would work yourself up. And this is actually the exact same incidents. And we can take another approach this time. We can actually include the sniper. So let's just take the rescue officers and the sniper, the commander, and then two normal officers. The rest of you can just stay home. Yeah, exact same incidents. And this is why we want to have more maps, so you don't just get the same incidents again, 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 again. So this time we will do something else. Because we will give these two guys some medical bags. We will give this guy his sniper rifle. And then we will just call in two ambulances right away. And just like all my other modifications, if you guys have some kind of ideas, some other functions, some new scripts, something, just let me know. And that is another approach to the same situation. We all saw that they were a clear threat to us. Not all suspects are arrested or removed from the scene. Is it possible for us to carry them? I don't think so, and we have probably messed up because we called two vehicles in at once. So yeah, this is the AT modification. Still a work in progress, and a ton of different stuff we need to add. We only have 10 more minutes before I have to leave, so I think I'm just gonna conclude this stream right here. We will not have time to boot up another round of emergency. I will say thank you very much for joining me. I hope you can have a fantastic Sunday evening and you enjoy it. And I'm excited for you guys to actually join me for the streams. And I will hope to see you again another time. This is BMA. Goodbye.